Why do I keep putting Baroque music in front of the live streams? The game that we're putting together is set in a sort of different fantasy period. When we started talking about Last Regiment and what we could do with a fantasy world, one of the big discussions was how can we make it not just another world with orcs and elves and crossbows and by the way, we do have orcs and elves and crossbows. All those are in our game. But how do we do that in a way that's interesting or different? And there's a lot of different story things that we could do, etc. But one of the sort of key things that we did from the beginning is we said, what if we move the time period forward a little bit? And instead of being in the Middle Ages, let's set it in a more modern time period with more modern technology and more modern things. And recently, this has become very important to me because I've been working on the lore and doing some world building and doing some writing for the game. As I do this, I've been thinking a lot about the Baroque period, and how we can introduce more elements from that Baroque period into our game, because that's sort of the time setting that we've chosen. The term Baroque actually comes from the Portuguese. There's a word baroco, I think, is what it comes from. And it means a weird shaped pearl. Not in a good connotation. It means a sort of negative connotation. And it's this idea that everything is sort of overly ornamented, it's exaggerated. And this term was actually applied to that music. Musicians of the Baroque period did not refer to themselves as Baroque musicians. The term didn't even exist at that time. At the time, they were just musicians. That was modern music for them. But later on in the 19th century, as we moved towards a much more simplistic style in our art and in our music, and when you start having, the naturalist movement and people trying to reflect the world as they actually see it, there was this feeling that everything that came before it was not speaking to the true spirit of the world. And you have these naturalist composers and these naturalist artists who are trying to show you the world as it really is. Baroque art was not about that at all. It was still very involved in trying to capture the beautiful and to capture the wonder of the world. And it doesn't really matter that the world is an ugly and terrible place. And then, the 1750s, the world was a terrible and ugly place. Terrible and ugly things were happening. But that's not what you put in your art. Art was to create something beautiful and to rise up above. Art should be something that lifts you above the mundane. It should be something special and beautiful. And that was the sort of idea behind Baroque and why Baroque exists. I love this period. I love everything about this period. And as we build the game out and as we work with the user interface and as we work with, how the game looks and how the game feels and how the people talk, this idea, this Baroque ideal of saying, we don't have to show the world as it actually is, but we want to show the world as it could be, as the divine could make it, as beautiful as something could be. I love this idea. I love this concept. It feels like something to me that the world has lost. And especially when I look at modern art, modern pop culture, modern things, I feel like the world has really lost this. If you ever spend any time thinking about modern architecture, for instance, just walk around your town and look at what we call modern architecture, and you look at this. We went through a period where we actually referred to architecture as brutalist architecture, and you think, well, who the fuck wants that? I don't want brutal architecture in my environment. And you see these big stone slabs and these big gray tenements, and everything is just, it's fucking ugly. And when you talk to the artists and the architects who develop these things, they'll tell you, well, we're trying to speak to the reality of the world. And I think, I don't want the reality of the world. I want to make the reality of the world better. I don't want to make art that reflects how shitty the world is. We should be looking at the world and saying that it is broken and it is ugly and they're bad things, but we can be better. And when you hear the sounds of an opera by Scarlatti, you are filled with the spirit of there is a greater, more beautiful thing that we could have together and we could build that. So that's my little lecture on Baroque and why we're using Baroque as a background for our game.